It's a bad year to be a mink, especially for the 17 million of them in Denmark that were ordered to be executed in November after a mutated strain of COVID-19 was discovered across mink farms, infecting 12 people and threatening vaccine efforts. Now, the future of this invasive species in Europe is doomed, bringing down Denmark's prized fur industry. While species such as dogs and cats have been found to catch COVID from humans, mink are the only known species capable of transmitting the virus back to humans. 5 mink-related strains were the cause of more than 50% of human COVID cases in the northern region of Denmark. American mink were introduced to Denmark in the 1930s. The country has since been the world's largest producer of mink fur, exporting around 19 million skins each year at a value of $1.3 billion. Now fingers are pointing at the Danish government for totally botching the coal and illegally ordering killings outside of the mandated infected zone. Videos have circulated Danish media showing the mishandled coal, including footage of mink still alive in a bin of dead mink and shoved in crowded bins. And now it's looking more like the plot of a zombie horror movie with hundreds of mink carcasses emerging from their graves. Gases from the decomposing mink most likely push the bodies up to the surface of their shallow graves, sparking even more outrage and prompting plants to dig them up and incinerate them. It makes sense that Denmark's agriculture minister, Mogens Jensen, has already resigned, and the opposition is calling for Denmark's prime minister, Mette Frederiksen, to step down.
Det har været fødselsdag for dem, og undskyld. Det er det også for mig.
Danish news outlets showed her crying on a visit to an empty farm, apologizing for illegally ordering the cull. The government cull has hurt mink farmers the most. Over 6,000 workers lost their livelihood across over 1,000 mink farms.
1,300 puppies and females are now gone. No more noises. No more looking at animals who are eating.
Brinkman's farm had to kill 25,000 mink after COVID was detected.
For my family, it means that we are gonna move, so I want to get closer to my mom and my dad and grandma.
Farmers across Denmark have been holding tractor demonstrations in protest of the cull.
Our daughter has been a strong 7-year-old girl. She can't sleep at night now, and she's sad and misses her animals.
Many still wonder if such rushed, drastic action was necessary.
I do honestly believe that it's necessary. There would have been a big increase in mink-related human cases if we had not taken out all the minks as it was decided.
I think, of course, we should kill a mink. It could impact a vaccine for corona.
Those antibodies are not effective against these mink-related strains. Then we're really in big trouble.
Some farmers believe the situation would have been avoided if the government acted faster.
They stopped doing it because they need to see how it developed. And I think that was a wrong decision. If we get a diseased farm, you need to kill it right away. We didn't hear anything from them for 14 days because what's going to happen now is that there will be no more mink in Denmark by the end of 2020.
But the death of the mink industry has been a long time coming. It's been bleeding in recent years. In 2019, the average mink farm was losing over $110,000, and the Danish mink industry went from a $1.5 billion valuation in 2012 to a $400 million valuation in 2019. The prices and demand for fur has decreased in recent years, with a greater sense of social responsibility felt surrounding animal welfare and environmental issues.
We need to be realistic and say this industry is finished now in Denmark, so all of us can get the properly money from the government.
Farmed mink are also extremely vulnerable to infections in general. Their crowded conditions and frequent exposure to other humans makes it very likely for viral infections to jump between species and mutate.
Minks seem to have some of the same receptors as we do for the virus to enter into the cells.
The mink pass infection through poop. The stool drops down, it becomes dust when it dries, and then the virus travels in that dust, making it actually airborne around the mink farms. Despite uncertainty of how exactly mink could impact a vaccine, the risk of transmission between mink and humans during future outbreaks has led countries such as the Netherlands to commit to phasing out the mink industry.
It's game over for us, and we need to keep our head high and get moving.